Condition has granted that we should make this complaint public. The issue is 7.5%. A lot of annual fees existing in the pension scheme, which ranges from the lack of pension scheme cost, and none of us can lay on whatsoever we contributed. Aside, there are a lot of other annual fees accompanying the pension scheme. Based on this, we call on the state government staff that if government cannot continue this contractual funding, up to all our. So what of the total we expect if for the many months government cannot accomplish this contractual funding, please, the months will contribute to the strong cause. Having said all this, I wish to go direct into the speech of my national president. On behalf of the entire members of the Noble Profession of Teaching in Nigeria, I very warmly welcome you all to the 2009 World Service Foundation. I would like to specifically welcome and acknowledge the presence of our professional colleagues of the teaching profession, employers of teachers, education providers, non-governmental organizations, international development partners, stakeholders, campus of industry, the factors and beneficiaries of education, industry, Nigerian Labour Congress, civil industrial union, civil society organizations, gentlemen of the press, and our dear celebration of this day in Nigeria. And for once again, partnering with the union this year to afford the teachers of Nigeria another opportunity to celebrate with their colleagues all over the world. We are particularly delighted to the presence of the Honorable Minister of Education, Labour, Employment and Productivity, as well as the Minister of State for Education, who have come to honor Teachers Day. The union, the Nigerian of Teachers NUC, is grateful to the federal government for institutionalizing the award of honor for deserving teachers who have increased themselves in the performance of their youth. The Presidential Teachers Award, which came into being in 2020 for winning this year's Presidential Award, we start of this year's World Challenge Presidential, which is aimed at developing education. The implementation of this map roadmap will be to attention SA and the Millennium Development Goal, MDG. The role of teachers as nation leaders and custodian of the future is working a big challenge to the vision and mission of both the federal and state government, of the respective government and the society. The fundamental questions that are inherent in this teacher's welfare: does the government consider teachers' demand as genuine enough against the boundaries? Is the quality of training and training of providers to ensure optimal service delivery as an assurance of nation unity? Is the environment under which teachers carry out their duty conducive enough to guarantee quality teaching? Is the state according to teachers who recognize and higher? It is important.
For many months now, this is unfortunate. It is even more
the 27.5 enhanced allowable and secondary school of the affected state. In the same in our universities and advanced further treatment in the subsector. 2020 of the federal government as human capital development and teachers in particular remain the center of the attainment of the goals. The instruction under 3 years. There is urgent need to have the political way to revamp the nation's education system. As a positive step in this regard, we call on government to consciously develop minimum of 5 modern primary schools and 2 modern secondary schools in each local government area out of the existing schools in the country, which will serve as secondary school landing. Top schools should be well equipped, adequately staffed with trained and qualified personnel, well funded and properly administered, so to serve as control and standard for other communities. This serves as a starting point by government to farm sector with a view to frequently extend sense to all schools in the country. It is equally imperative for us to reflect on our school system and instead of the nation overall budget. The agency is of the same belief that a credible election, not of good government, rule of law, can be a sure way of producing leaders with the urban integrity through the of this commission.
The help us in write exam. Yeah. Abi, if you like, make you no read. It is a God will come help you write up. Now when do you write? Now then
go
give
you. Go pass. Pass
as I trust that. She says she won't become doctor. I go come be mama doctor. Then when they greet me, I'm gonna do like this. I'm gonna do like this. What do you say you want become?
Mama accountant.
Accountant, plenty money. Money, money. My daughter, what do you say you want to become?
I'm an engineer.
Engineer, my pikin go build big moto, big one. So you what do you want to become?
For me, not teacher.
And I am proud to be a teacher because what God has, the knowledge God has given me, I've been imparting to all my students. Yes. Look, I am not just talking. All the commissioners. Yes. So, just wait.
If when you teach children, you remain for one place. You pretty prejudice for everywhere. See God now. Where do you not?
God will reward me. I saw your mother asking you some questions. Mm. And what did you say you want to become?
I'm a doctor.
Doctor? Yes. That.
Because he had an LCE,
can have also a teaching degree up to his PhD. And in fact, we took him out of the classroom to come and be secretary to the government of Nigeria. Believe me, I have always been proud of this young teacher, who at the beginning, when many of his colleagues and many of the politicians did not understand the role of secretary to the government were on his case. But I think now they realize that this teacher is an asset to Nigeria's state. The head of service, who also I think his background is more in agriculture, he would have been a teacher, but he decided not to be. Because of what the mother or the children or were paid. And at the state level, I was elected the national secretary and the state secretary of Nigeria Labour Congress, and in subsequent election, I became the chairman of the Nigeria Labour Congress. I was a permanent member of the negotiating team of Nigeria Labour Congress. As a result of that labor union too, I was appointed a member of the Board of Governors of Kaduna Polytechnic, representing labor unions. I'm going to this detail to see if some of you may not appreciate why, when we talk of labor unions, or particularly AUT, that I tend to be animated and become very interested and really have to do whatever I can do to assist. Because not only have I been interested, but I've seen it also as a foundation for whatever I may become or have become. So for me, teacher and teaching is a pride. Teacher and teaching is a fulfilling career. Teacher and teaching is something that you can always be proud of, because it's something you will never retire of until God retires you. I was watching when we were watching the play by Wahid. They say teacher are not corruption because you don't get money to steal and lie. Because corruption is not only in stealing. It's not only in stealing money. A teacher who does export is corruption. A teacher who befriends his student is corruption. A teacher who uses or whatever uses his position to get the benefit that he would not normally get is corruption. So we must pay attention. It is not only the stealing money. And by the way, who said that there is no money to steal? Ask the Commissioner of Education. Because we discovered at the time that, and I consider even administrators and teachers, because just because you're a principal or a headmaster, that does not mean you're not a teacher, because you organize, in fact you make, you are more of a teacher, because whatever you do reflects on the people that you supervise. If the principal collects school fees and reduces the amount, or refuses to declare the real amount, that is also corruption. If a principal or a teacher increases the number of the people who will sit for examination so that he can have more fees, that is corruption. so that other people who it is not by choice, but by accident that they fall into the career, do not end up spoiling our career. There was a time when many people thought, and it became an adage. They say those who can do, and those who cannot teach. That is not true. You don't make teaching a dumping ground. And I'm happy that now we have the teachers' registration council. That you have to have certain qualifications to be able to register. Many people, it was true, that when they tried so many things, that those were the times when somebody who reads Bible knowledge, who actually wanted to be a bank manager, when they try bank, they don't get. They try other places, they don't get, then they talk to you. Please, if they are still around, let us flush them out. Because teaching is the foundation of development of any community. Once you have good teachers, believe me, you will have an excellent foundation for education and an excellent future for your children. But if you limit for failures, for those who have nothing else to do, to join you, then you erode that strong foundation that you have laid. So if sometimes you see me getting more annoyed with teachers or teaching, it is because I feel inside me that I'm a permanent teacher. Believe me, I think even if they didn't know I have a chance, I would teach. Because in other societies, career is a self-selection. Right from your young days, you know what you want to be. If you choose to be a policeman, you find that you like control, you can be wicked when the time comes. Are you the sympathetic type? The one who cares, who wants to take care of people? Right from primary school, you know you are in self-selection, you begin to go to nursing, you begin to go to medicine. Not because it brings money, but because that is naturally what you want to do. So even in the training, it becomes a natural thing for you to do. And you don't fail it because that is what you want to do. But you find somebody who has even failed teaching practice in the teaching profession. Anybody who does not get a particular set should not register, no matter how he passes or not. And we should be able to also take him. And that is where the NUT comes in. It is not only in the trade union job. We want this, we want this. No. What will the NUT do also to protect the career, to protect the profession? So it must have this dual relationship. A trade union and also a professional organization that can protect the career and the profession. I see even my job now as a chief servant of 9 or 10 as a teacher. In fact, the challenge is more in the teacher. To let people understand how things are done, to let them know that the money of the state government is people's money. It's not for the few who know the governor or the few who think they can blackmail the governor to come and give them money. How can you abuse me and expect me to be afraid and clean and come and give me money? If you abuse me in your house, now you and your wife here. If you come to the street and abuse me, so that's what I'm saying. So if you are used to abusing people to get money, something else. This game is very clear. Because we need to change the perception of the game. If I am going to share the money of government, then there will be no job done. We must know this zero-sum game is not a game which is either you do this or you do that. And we must educate the people to understand it. And I have resolved that as long as I am the governor of Niger State, I won't, even if I have to fight everybody, I will not fight a civil servant. I will make sure that whatever condition we are in, we pay the salary of civil servants at any given time that they are here. But in the same way, I also expect that the civil servants will give their own dues back, meaning the teachers will teach. The teachers will be in their schools. The teachers will not only see their role as only in the classroom. No, teachers are role models. In our times of 30, 40 years ago, when a teacher does not see a pupil in the classroom, but even in time he is in the house of that child to find out whether he was sick or something. And those of us who were branching instead of going to school would go and drink mango, climb mango tree. At least by evening time our parents will know we were not in the classroom. I know the challenge is small now. A classroom of 80 pupils, a classroom of 100 people, you may not notice. But if you are diligent, you will still notice. And that is why we say we should introduce teachers' assistants. Who will assist the teachers? So those who are not qualified to be registered teachers should be appointed as teaching assistants so that as a teacher, so that as a teacher, a qualified teacher is teaching, his ones are assisting him to make sure that the class is in order. I think it is not just a coincidence that today is a teacher's day, and today is World Happiness Day. And I know in our days, and that is why I emphasize it, that the day I reported to my school was the day I was given the key to my house. And up to today, sometimes out of nostalgia, I drive into Government Teachers College, the present or the temporary site of MUT. The house is still standing there. A two-bedroom building that served a beautiful flowers. No, I didn't get a chance to do so much inside because I reported in September and I got married in December. Because of other things. But the coincidence I'm happy, and I know that many teachers now even retire without a home of their own, which is rather unfortunate, because whoever serves for 35 years or it is 60 years should not have a problem of a house. And that's why I'm emphasizing that we should have houses at the local government level or at the state capital, and I believe the Commissioner of Education would want to try to make sure that teachers are given priority in the allocation of houses. And if And if it becomes necessary, I hope and I'm going to direct her to relate properly with the Commissioner of Housing so that the mortgage will be able to find it easier for the teachers. So it is in the same direction that I'm setting up a small committee of the Commissioner of Education, the Commissioner of Local Government, and the Chairman of Subay, with the Chairman of Niger Tech NUT, his Secretary, and his Treasurer, the six of them, to sit down and look at that 7.5% that had been collected from primary school teachers and had not been counterfunded, and recommend what we should do. Because even if it is returned back to the teachers, within 2-3 days, they may spend it. What about if it forms the nucleus of their percentage for housing? But look at it. Let's hold it. Establish, even if they decide to pay it back, how much will it be that each teacher may have? We don't have that problem with secondary school teachers. It's only with the Subay and the connection with part of 2007 and part of 2008. And if the committee meets and recommended, if they want to recommend, they may recommend that the state government must find a way to counterfund it. Because this is a retirement benefit. At the moment, you may be eager, you want to collect it and spend it. But I'm much more concerned with the day you are leaving your job. Because at that time, at 60 years, or given 35 years, if the benefit is so small, believe me, you will suffer more of it. The immediate gratification for the individual is, give me my thing, let me spend. Yes, it's normal. Maybe if I was sitting on the other side, I may be more vocal in saying, give us something for shiny. But I'm concerned. So this committee of six people, let them sit down, look at what it is, how much has it accrued to, what is the benefit. For example, some people have been allocated houses, MIOCC. They have been told to pay the initial 10% so that they could collect the key. Many people are finding it difficult to give 10% of 2.something million or 1.something million. Because for a teacher, well, I don't know now, but for a teacher, at the time we started teaching, my NC incidentally was 300 and something naira. And believe me, well, it was enough to do quite a lot, and even to buy Palumbo. But after you have spent it, nothing much to save. And I don't know how many of you have been able to save from your salary on your own. Because the idea is that many of you now, by the time you're collecting, you are paying a debt. By the time you are expecting, you have already entered another debt. So if so is the case, we must assist one another. Because a day will come when you will wake up, there is no salary to collect. It is only what you have been able to save that you will see through. So allow this committee to make recommendations. And if they decide to co-opt whatever, please feel free to co-opt. Because I have seen Mr. Balai, who was the chairman of NUT in 1978-79-80, Mr. Balai is not up to be recognized. And I know now you are retired. And I know now you are collecting pension. And I know your pension is not enough. Only if you have been able to build houses where people are rich and money. Thank you very much, sir. So we will, that committee will look at it. And that committee too will study the president's address. So the issues that have been raised there, the one that we need to improve upon, because I showed you the address where since 2007, I made that recommendation. In fact, I was thinking maybe they saw where I said in each local government we should pick some schools to turn them into model schools. Where we should be able to pump enough money to make them model enough so that whatever that is to be done, even if it is to be a reference point where other teachers could be brought there to see what could be done with equipment and hope that we should be able to do it. I see that in 2009, the president is still talking about it. So we'll study the speech and see what we can do as a state government. I've also asked the commissioner whether we have started implementation. We said the schools in the rural areas in particular. In our days, there used to be teachers' compound in the private schools in rural areas. We have a problem now. Many teachers who are posted to rural areas, they don't stay. The ones that stay pay more attention to their family. And when you come to the cities, you will find that in one school, you have more teachers than you need. Because those who can do chukuchuku corruption, they are posted to the schools in urban areas. We call for the vision of all the education offices, the chairman of local government, to make sure that people who accept to work must be ready to work wherever they are posted. But we will do it with a human touch. But there is nothing wrong if the local government post a teacher. Maybe that's what I like example, because everywhere is actually Bosu, local government. There is nothing wrong in posting somebody to charter the Okoro. Because what we are trying to do is to make sure that there are buses in town that you can wake up, reliable ones, that you can wake up and know the time that a bus will leave your bus stop to a particular area. And if you know it, then it doesn't matter whether you are in Kodo, or you are in Chekega, or your husband is in Mina, or your wife is in Mina, and you'll be posted out. Indeed, we have taken the policy that Greater Mina is now from Kodo to Paipu, from Garatu to Kwada. And if transportation is available, in fact, the College of Education that is likely to be sited in Gweda will still serve the purpose of Mina, because with the bus ride is about 30 to 40 minutes to Gweda. So you don't have to go and stay there to be in College of Education. You can still stay in Mina to be in College of Education. Now don't get me wrong, somebody should not go and quote me that I said I'm moving College of Education. I think what I'm saying is that with the new policy whereby the basic quality of education, the one that will be teaching, that will be teaching or training the teachers that will be teaching in the primary schools, unlike the present curriculum that we are having, will have to be established, and that is supposed to take place in 2010. So whether we leave this one or we create another one, or we end up with two, it means we must have one that now introduces the new curriculum of NC. That is what I'm saying. We are also looking at the possibility of bringing back the rural teaching allowances. Because many of us enjoy it. When I finished the grade 2 in 1974, I didn't remember that in one of the debates that I abused one of the education officers. In a debate, I was accusing an officer in 1974. And in 1974, I was how old? 18, 18. So you can imagine, the same Babangere is the one standing here. It's not nobody to give me the in. So the man retaliated by making sure I was wanted to put up. But then I knew in my bones that I passed my grade 2. So I reported to Kuta 1 week after I went to college education before the result came out. But because my name was there in the register, they gave me Odoji. You know, they were doing in 1973, I was paid for Odoji. Because I reported, and my name was in register, so I worked for 2 months, and I was entitled to my Odoji. It was the one I bought machine, Yamaha 100. And I wrote it from Sokoto to Mina. Every vacation, I was riding my machine from Sokoto to Mina. But that time, things were peaceful. Don't try it now. The Teachers Award, secretary to the government, we have introduced the awards for Niger State. I think we should have specific ones for teachers' awards. I think this committee should also look at how to operationalize it. Local government by local government and the category of teachers. And the kind of reward and the kind of recognition that should be given so that other teachers will try to emulate. That's the whole idea of recognizing people. Believe me, I was the happiest person when I read in the paper that Niger State NUT is not going on the national strike. My happiness was and is that you have realized in the federal system we cannot have the old centralized union approach. I told you, and that's the purpose of bringing back the history. During the military, it was a unitary system. Is this one done?
During the military, that's one in the town. It was a unitary system. From the Supreme Commander.
If the federal government in the Supreme Headquarters, a decision is taken, it's only a question of sending a signal to the military governors, and all of them, and 6 of them, will all implement. So it was easy for a union to say, let us fight the federal government, because once the federal government decides, everybody will comply. But with the constitution that runs the system, it cannot be so. Federal government is an employer. The state governments are employers. And that is why the federal government took the principal position that whatever it agreed with us cannot be the same with the state universities. We have a state university that has in its law. One of the governors put it in its law that if you agree to work in that university, you cannot even be a member of ASU. So that is before you join, you already know that. So federal government, if you go to negotiate,
That is for those in the federal system. If I were, and I've been given this example, I told the governor of River State, that if I were, if I was getting the same resources that River State is getting, I would pay my civil servant higher than what the federal government is paying, because I work for it. But the case is not the same. In fact, with the economic meltdown, many of the states have suffered. Niger State has lost 40% of what it was receiving. I am aware that there are some states who, for the past 3 months, have not been able to pay salaries. So you cannot go and take an agreement at the center and impose it on the state, because what it will mean is that you will either close the universities if a state has one, or rationalize the employees if you have to pay them the same kind of thing. I'm happy that at least everybody is coming to his senses with regard to hustle strike, and I hope that at least this will be the last time that people will be holding us to ransom. We must understand what is happening now. NUT, you are aware. Because I remember in 1982, we were at the World Confederation of Teaching Profession in the March in Switzerland. And I was one of the representatives of Nigerian teachers in that one. All over the world now, the union must have an endowment fund. For example, United States teachers, and I hope this committee will look at that possibility. Let us raise some funds that will not be spent now, but probably keep it in an account that will be growing, or invest. If at any time the NUT decides to go on strike against the chief servant, and the chief servant decides to invoke the law of no work, no pay, you will be able to give your teachers something so that they are not black men back to work. But where are now if you go on strike, you are not paid for the first month, for the second month, for the third month. That is if I invoke that one. And then I look at the law again that gives me the power to dismiss anybody. And then I say, all the teachers in the secondary school, I hereby dismiss, and then I'm going to employ you fresh. Well, now the law is there. Let's get the money out of here. So I am saying what they do in Canada, and I remember Leverett, some teachers came to me from Canada, even when I came here as a chief servant. So they have some money which they were giving their employees when on strike. So, and they have ways of negotiation. They don't have to wait until they go on strike. The negotiation channel is open, so that as problems arise, they are easily negotiated. You don't wait until they accumulate so much. And I remember I told the head of service to adopt the same approach with the NLC, that we must not wait until things are broken to mend them. Now, anyone that we see in the process of breaking, let us mend it quickly. So that's all why I'm bringing all this things to you. And I hope that the NUT, or madam, that your committee should find a way to begin the seed money. Now, even if there is no strike, after, for example, 5 years, you start with an endowment fund, for example, of 5 million naira. After 5 years in an investment, you may find that is enough to do other things, to build a beautiful secretariat
that you will have a hole like this or better than this one. Because this will be my shoe. They do tuku-tuku now. We'll have our Lord in heaven. But the work that we do on us, let me get my reward on us. After all, what I did, I knew I don't get to bed. So whether I'm paid or I'm rewarded as a teacher, you know, we'll see. So let me have my own here. What I get will be bonus. So, madam, make sure that we negotiate properly and that all information, and you should congratulate the NUT of Niger State for being bold enough. Because normally in another place they would have said they are going in sympathy. What is concerning with sympathy of somebody? Because I remember when this issue of TSS came up. I recall that I raised the issues and how we can go about it. Some people said no, that they know they want to discuss with the NUT National. So we set up a small committee. Unfortunately for us, many of the members. I must acknowledge the chief servant, sir, that the entire teachers of Niger State and those privileged to be here were earnestly today happy to find you in their midst as a court colleague, as an old colleague, and colleague indeed to grace this epoch-making occasion. We are proud of you. And we remain proud of you. Because you always acknowledge history and remember where you started. And for some people may be wondering, what kind of governor do we have that is so focused, that is hardly bent? For us who have been close to you for quite some time, we know the orientation is gotten from the principles you are able to acquire in the trade union movements. And that's why today we are proud to say teachers who are privileged to be leaders in this country have clearly demonstrated excellence in terms of administering or carrying out their leadership role. But I think as a brother, as a Indian veteran to the core of us, you have said it all, other friends of yours in prayer, to see the successful tailor that the hope of your colleagues you want to remind the servants to not only direct, but ensure
what we're doing and what we intend to do, and knowing that if we get the teachers right, we will get our education right. If we get our education right, then we'll be able to achieve our vision 2020. So the neglect that they have suffered before, we are making the correction. A teacher and any employee should be trained and trained. And all his allowances and salaries should be paid to him when, as and when. And you also try to give him all the incentives and more motivation. And for me, coming from the background, I have taken it as a personal incentive. And that is what we're doing now. We're doing whatever it is to make sure, and I'm happy, that the teachers in Niger State